shorter stream this morning because I'm tired. I felt like going back to Death Ray Manta. See how far I can get. I'm really looking forward to Castlevania and getting back to some kinds of. That was super close. And so was that, I almost got shot there. With the blue enemy there. I don't think I've ever seen Curse of the Mummy's Tomb, but I'm pretty sure Boris Karloff and maybe also Bela Lugosi's in it, I think. I'm not 100% sure. They did a lot of mummy movies way back in the 30s and 40s. I wonder how the developer of this game decided on the order of the level names. Like, the horror movies are all over the place. 60s again, maybe 70s, early 70s. This has been such a long week and I'm so tired. Maybe this is like their favorite list of movies in order. I can't picture what kind of order it's in since it's not in chronological order. Night of the Living Dead is really a tough level. Like, I've messed that level up so many times. I almost didn't see that orange fish or whatever it is. guess this is Friday the 13th, which is 80s. Maybe it was late 70s, I'm not sure. I never got around to watching any of the Friday the 13th, even though I have the complete series box set that came out a couple years ago. Now, I've never cared to see any of the Texas Chainsaw movies. Not my type of horror film. Nor the Saws. I like the classic, like, over-the-top, silly type of horror movies, like Vincent Price and Peter Lorre and stuff that they were in. The Fly with Vincent Price is really good. I have the box set for that too, which includes the Jeff Goldblum movies. And I've seen bits and pieces of those on TV, but I've never watched all of the Jeff Goldblum one. 36, that was so close to a PB. I didn't even look at the letter name on that one. I doubt I'm gonna get that high again. Sometimes I just get in the zone, but most of the time it's not. I can't even remember when this game came out now. This is a super cool game. I'm glad this came out. There was a period where twin stick shooters were all the rage, and there was a bunch of them coming out at the same time. And this just wound up being one of my favorites. Oh, here we go. The hard one. Oh, sniped. That happens a lot. If I can get past Night of the Living Dead, I am usually good for a number of stages after that. It's just getting past the Night of the Living Dead level is really tough. It's been years since I've seen the original Night of the Living Dead. Which one is it? Where they're in the shopping mall. Not the remake. I really didn't like. I think it's Dawn of the Dead. I loved the 70s version of that movie. I didn't care for the 90s or 2000 remake of it, but I don't know what it was about that one, but I really like that one. Day of the Dead, the original Day of the Dead, was okay too. Teaching the zombie to be a soldier or whatever, I thought that was pretty funny. But the shopping mall one, out of the three originals, was my favorite. I actually have that on Blu-ray. It's an import. I don't have too many import discs that weren't later re-released locally. Did I get past Night of the Living Dead and then immediately die? I wasn't paying attention to what level I was on. Movies I want to try to watch in October. It's gonna be there. Theme wise, they're gonna be all over the place. I don't know if I'll get around to watching a full series of anything. Except subspecies. Because it's been so long since I've seen those, I don't want to watch the new entry before I watch, rewatch the old ones. My Steelbook Collector's Edition of, Coraline came in, yesterday. It's been probably 10 plus years since I've seen that movie. I know it's the 4K Steelbook version. I'm really excited to watch that one for Halloween. I've been putting off for years the Friday the 13th box set. Mostly because, that snake they kill in the movie was a real snake, and it was some guy's pet, apparently, and they didn't tell him that what they were going to do beforehand, and then he's off-camera crying because they just killed his pet snake. So I've never been able to bring myself to watch the first Friday the 13th movie because of that. I keep saying I'm just going to skip the first movie and just watch the rest of them, but I still haven't managed to do it. And I was reading about Don't Look Now with Donald Sutherland or whatever, and apparently there's some infamous sex scene in it or something, and that might be why I keep putting that off too. Maybe I can just fast forward through that. I don't care to see that. But I heard it's a... Besides that, I think it'd be a really cool movie. Funny, I wanted to watch mostly stuff that I have on disc this year, but I've been getting emails from like streaming services or whatever, and there's like three or four really cool looking horror movies coming to streaming services in September and October and all. All these look really cool to be able to watch for Halloween. So maybe I'll do a couple streaming movies also. Because at least two of them looked really cool. And I was like, oh, I have to watch that. I cannot remember the names of them offhand. But I wrote them down on my to-watch IMDb list. I couldn't remember where the dot was. Curse of the Mummy's Tomb, this might be getting closer. Friday the 13th. The blue guys. I soul, and I'll Manta you. That's a funny name. Okay, here we go. Texas Chainsaw Manta. That was kinda close. I'm glad there's no blue ones in this one. That would be ridiculously hard. The Wicker Manta. I've seen both. The original with Christopher Lee and the remake with Nick Cage, and I really liked both, but for different reasons. This is a horrifying movie. The Manta Finder General with Vincent Price. Oh, of course, 37. Teenage werewolf one. That was close. I can't remember the last time I got past the teenage werewolf level. Yeah, I have the Witchfinder General poster hanging up right behind me. Definitely one of the darkest movies that Vincent Price was in. The Pit and the Pendulum is one of my favorites, which was that same Roger Corman Poe era film. Oh, I can't believe I died there. Yeah, right into the blue guy. Apparently, they're re-releasing the first Ghoulies movie on 4K. I have both of those on disc already. They were good movies, I like those ones. The first one more so than the second. That's the same thing I did then, other level. Okay. Or maybe it was the same one. I don't even know anymore. I've pretty much got the placements of the orb memorized for the first dozen or so levels. Like, my hands will automatically steer the ship towards it. Except this one. I did not remember that one. This month, it'll be nice to get back to platformer games. That's the second time in a row I've died there. Maybe I'll finally play some, after October, play some indie platformers on the Switch that I've been putting off, like Super Bimbo World and stuff like that. I've been putting off that Cthulhu one that I cannot remember the name of now. Where you have the claws and it's really bloody. I've been putting that one off for years. Maybe I'll get around to that one eventually. I don't know what it is. I used to play a ton of shmups when I was younger. I guess maybe my eyesight's gotten worse and I've moved more to platformers or whatever. It might be nice to play a first-person shooter for a change, because I very rarely play any of those. I did replay and beat the remake of the Turok game years ago, and then I just never got around to playing the second one. I know the third one got announced. I didn't even know they did a third one on the N64, which is hard to think about. Because I never even got around to playing Turok 2 on the N64. But maybe I could play Turok 2 on the Switch at some point. First-person shooters, just because of how they're made, with the having to aim and depth perception things, is really difficult for me. So I tend to not play first-person shooters. I've been so tired and stressed, I can't even remember the last time I picked up Diablo 4. There's no way I'm gonna even finish the main story in Diablo 4 before my PS Plus runs out. At the rate that I'm going, there's 7 acts in story mode, and I just barely was able to finish Act 1, like last month or something, which is nuts, because I think isn't Season 2 in Diablo 4 starting soon, maybe, in October I think sometime. I definitely didn't get to play Season 1, I'm definitely not going to get to play Season 2. Apparently, that new remake by the people who made The Messenger of the Chrono Trigger-like game that I can't remember the name of now, is one of the free games with PS Plus, so I have it on the PS5. I haven't played that either, though. I was either going to get that, oh, the blue guys, every time. Which level was that? I can't remember. I keep forgetting to look at the level names. Then I look at the level name and then I'm dead. Physical version of that new Chrono Trigger-like game isn't coming out on the Switch till 2024. I don't know if I will get around to it before then. I tend to not play big, popular games right when they come out, ever. I was worried about, I just barely dodged the triangles there, and then I got hit by the orange guy. reminds me, I finally found the stores restocked the strawberry lemonade Gatorade. So I'm really looking forward to that eventually. Sometimes I can shoot the stationary objects, and other times I just completely miss them. I think. I haven't watched very many werewolf movies. A couple years ago, I think I watched the werewolf movie where they're all stuck on a train with the werewolves. I don't remember the name of that one. Too many more attempts, I don't think. I don't know if I'm ever gonna see the end of this game. If there is even one. There has to be, right? I know there's a million different movies, but the movie title names can't go on forever, right? Didn't die that time, I'm shocked. Say that was one of my favorite movies. I have a poster of that in my room. I I tend to gravitate more towards, like, older horror movies, I guess. There's a couple new ones that I found cool and or interesting, but I usually watch, like, stuff from the 60s and 70s and 80s. Less so the 80s. That was actually really close. I missed it, and then I went back and got hit, like, of course. This might be my last attempt for this morning. I got a late start. I still haven't watched Twins of Evil yet, the Hammer and Dracula movie. I watched The Vampire Lovers and Lust of a Vampire, but I still haven't watched Twins of Evil. I did want to see that one because Peter Cushing's in it. Okay. Alright, I think that's good for now. I've been too exhausted and stressed to play the last in the evenings for the last, what, 2 or 3 weeks going on now? But we'll see, I guess. Until next time.